The approach is, what do you have that you're really good at, and how do you leverage that? It's not how do you get yourself out of a corner. That's not why you go into a business, how do I get myself out of a corner? The other business I'm in is so bad that I'm going to go into another business so I can, that's not the way it works. Not for me. So I don't think that a lot of, and I know a lot of the CEOs, I don't think that a lot of them approach it that way. They actually are trying to leverage the assets, the skills, the things that make them different in a broader set. And I think that's a good thing to do. That's a good thing for American business.
Let's talk about the economy.
And what economy? Do we have an economy? You tell me about the economy.
Well, let me give you the vote. We have a bunch of economists at Forrester, and we are saying that the tech economy, this is worldwide, will grow about 10% this year. By the way, the U.S. will be the slowest growing, growing about 7%. So we're about 10% IT growth this year, but dropping in 2012 to about 9.5%. So the tech economy, to us at least, feels very, very strong. Is that what you're feeling out there?
No. Not at all.
You think we are? Well, my view of this. My view of this is that we're crawling a wall of glory, which says we've come out of a bad recession, and that every setback, people are throwing up their hands and saying, "Have a good time." We're going to a recession, but my belief is that we're going to slowly pull out of this recession, and it's not going to be a brilliant recovery, but it will take 2 to 3 more years.
I agree with that. I agree that we are definitely in a recovery mode. But I mean, we have short memories in America, and shorter memories in business. It's very annoying. So you got to remember.
We're going to talk about that.
Yeah, you got to remember 2009. The Google reference 2009. It was horrible. It was, I mean, literally, I remember sitting in the movies in 2009 where we thought we were going to close down. Not Xerox, I mean the world. The world is going to implode. We quickly forget these things and we say, oh, well, yeah, but now, you know, growth of 10%, slow recovery. We are in a slow recovery back to a level of growth over 2009, but very few people are back to 2007, 2008, no, maybe 2008, because 2008 ended up being at the end
of the year. We're not talking about the tech economy, we're talking about the general.
The general economy. Yeah. So there's a, we are better than we were in 2009, still trying to get back to like the third grade, kind of like being left back.
Yeah.
And you say, now I'm back to the, you know, the fifth grade, which is where I should have been 2 years ago. So that's basically where we are. So what do I see with the economy? I think we have a certain set of facts in the United States and around the world, the United States primarily. And I'm removing for the world right now China. That's the one place. I'm not even India. I'm going to include India in this discussion, China outside, because they have a very different system, a very different set of dynamics in their marketplace. Most developed economies have structural unemployment that's higher today by orders of magnitude, measurable orders of magnitude, than they've had in their recent past. The United States has it.
But Germany would be.
Germany is excluded from that. Germany is the, I was going to get to Germany. Germany is the one economy that is sitting there. We should all rush there and try to sell things to the Germans. They're growing.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's what everybody else is doing. But the United States has unemployment. Structural unemployment at 9-10%. Well, you know, I think you can make any number you want, but I think when you get to 9, and you say 9 is for real, that means you're like at 12 or 13, right? The southern European countries are at structural unemployment in 20% numbers. You go to the UK, they have double digit unemployment. So you say to yourself, okay, 10%, these are millions and millions of people don't work. They have families who they cannot take care of. And the way that they are taking care of those families, they're drawing on a central pool of resources that the people who do work throw into, or the governments throw into by creating debt. So while I think that we can find companies that are doing better in the short term, they're manipulating positively the market, their position in the market to do better, I think we're in for a pretty difficult.
But you're in agreement. It's a slow crawling up the wall word.
Yeah.
Every 2%.
I don't think it's worry though. Worry would mean to me that there is a concern with not a lot of backing.
Yeah.
Or, you know,
yeah.
I think this is not worry. This is reality. Mm. We're going to have years of Xerox Corporation and Ursula Burns making the earnings number, we will absolutely do it. And there's no doubt about it. Underneath that, how we get to those numbers, how everybody is to literally manage really tightly around the vest, really tightly. And that's not ideal. It constrains risk. It constrains chance. It constrains starts. I just don't feel it. We didn't make the economy that we have today by operating so close to the vest. I think that we are in for a set of changes if we don't figure out a way to loosen it up. And when I listen to these economists, which I try not to ever listen to, in the TV programs that drive me crazy, because they actually don't live in the real world. They live in numbers, right? They do numbers, they do analysis about numbers. And I get up every day, and most of us do, when we walk into an office building. And as we walk into the office building, you walk into people who are nervous about their jobs, you walk into people who are telling you what they're really doing, not the culmination of a set of numbers, but individuals that say, I don't think I can send my kid to college. You know, there's a whole bunch of reality that kind of averages out that way.